Hello everyone, Adam here. First, I wanted to apologize that I haven't posted any videos for at least 6 months. And today I wanted to show you the latest version of my microphone jammer that is built from the Digispark unit here. A set of 25 kHz transducers. These are named T25 or something. They are collected all in parallel. Of course, we have this audio amplifier, so we have a big change here because this one is capable to give you up to 100 of watts of audio power. This is TPA3116D2, but this one particular, this one has only single audio channel, so it is connected only with these two cables to the input socket, and it also has a potentiometer, so you can adjust the power that you want to get from these transducers. And the important thing is that you need to power it from the battery that has at least 12 volts. I have here only 5 volts, but it still works, but it gives less power, less audio power. But you can start with 5 volts. Okay, the Digispark, if you power it from the higher voltage than 5 volts, this battery actually has 5 volts, but if you power it from higher voltage, it needs to be connected with the V-in pin, the one, to this power source. So that is why I'm having these two, audio amplifier and Digispark, connected in parallel from this battery. Okay, so when you switch it on, in 5 seconds it will start generating the signal. Here, as I mentioned, it is not much because the power is not sufficient. Okay, so it generates the noise, but in real life you should think of powering this whole device from 12 volts at least. So in real life you should build something different. I will show you in a minute. Okay, so the real unit, the real jammer, looks like this. It has a plenty of transducers here, so this is not enough. It should be like, I think, 40, at least, maybe 20. And it is powered from the power source that has 12 volts, at least 1 amp. So depending on this power, you will get appropriate audio power. So if it's 12 volts and 1 amp, it will give you only 12 watts, right? But anyway, I have fitted all of these inside a small box. So I have this, let's call it Digispark. So it is 80Tiny85, powered from the voltage stabilizer 5 volt. It gets the power from these 12 volts from here, and it provides 5 volt for the chip. And then the output of it is connected to the input of this TPA3116D2. And then the output of the TPA is connected to the set of transducers, which are all connected in parallel, right? Okay, let me switch it on. So this one is a, I would say, kind of jamming beasts. Let me switch it on. I have to connect it, you know, to the power grid, right? Okay, 3, 2, 1, go. Okay, I switched that one off. I hope you heard something, right? Okay, let me now go to the Arduino to show you what were the changes that I made into the source code. See you in a while.
Okay, let's now see the source code and what were the changes that I made. First of all, whole information and whole data of the project is available on GitHub. Here's the page, so github.com, mcore19676, antispy-jammer, and here you can find everything, whole history of the project, as well as the latest design. So it is available here. So as I mentioned, you need to use at least 12 volts to power this TPA3116D2, because otherwise you'll get too less power to jam the devices. And there were many questions if it can jam iPhones. Yes, it can very successfully jam the iPhones, but you need huge power. You need at least 20 or 40 transducers. You will see that on the end of this video. I have a video from one of my viewers. Thank you very much for this. I will try to show you to attach it on the end. And you need a strong battery, and you need a battery to capable to provide at least several amps to this device. So then you will achieve enough power to jam everything, including iPhones. Okay, let's go to the source code. Ah, yeah, one more thing. So if you want to try a version that operates on 40 kilohertz with the 40 kilohertz transducers, here is the one. But I must admit that from my findings, only 25 kilohertz are most successful. So try with the 25 kilohertz first and then go to the 40. Okay, let's now go to the source code. In the source code, which is available, of course, here, this is mic-jammer ino. You can see that the changes that I made were the table, the predefined table of randomized values for the pulse length. And this was to provide randomization of the frequency and the amplitude of the signal. So I'm using these values to create a pulse with appropriate length. And one more else was done. So I'm sending 25 of pulses, and then I'm switching the length of the pulse to the other value. These are 4096 values of length pulse, of pulse length, and this is changed every 25 pulses. Why is that? This is because if you divide 25 kilohertz by 25, you will get 1000. So it is 1 kilohertz, the center frequency that you want to jam, right? This is a center frequency of human ear. And that is why it works very well. Okay, of course, you may want to play with these values. If your device does not provide 25 kilohertz center frequency, you may want to adjust this value. This is something that you can play with, right? Okay, I think that is all from my side. I hope you'll try this design. It works very well. And see you. And please subscribe my channel and press like button. Thank you very much. Bye bye.
¿Cómo de infalible es tu sistema? Es decir, habitualmente...